So let's get started with maybe one question. Amal Jyoti College, Kerala, any questions?
Asked you earlier. Now, suppose you are considering a person, a man who is standing inside a room, and suppose the walls of the room are having a temperature which is greater than the temperature of the human body. Suppose a room is having a greater temperature. Now, the room will emit some radiations and it will be absorbed by the man. Now, after that, instead of a man, suppose there is an object there. Okay. Now, after absorption, it will transmit some amount of radiation. Now, it is going to be transmitted and it is going to be hitting on the same surface itself. So, in that concept, do we want to take the transmitted amount of radiation?
See, the question is actually this is, the question is if I put a body inside a furnace and there is an interaction of the body and the wall, and do we have to take the transmissivity also into account? I think you will have to, we will be answering this question. We will be in fact solving a problem on this. So, you will have to wait until I solve. The point is there is view factor which is taken into account. I have to take into account the irradiation and also the emission. So, this is the point. But anyway, you will be able to appreciate this when we get to the, when we complete the basics of radiation. Okay. So, I am going to get started where we stopped. See, where we said that the black body radiation is, the radiation depends on the temperature of the material, wavelength of the emission, surface roughness, but not considering the wavelength, temperature and the surface roughness. If I define an ideal body, that is the black body, which absorbs, what is a black body? It has to satisfy three conditions. It should absorb all the energy which is incident on it, and it should emit maximum amount of energy. No one should be able to emit more than the black body, and black body has no preference for direction. That is, it is a diffuse emitter. That is, black body is this. This is not black body. This is black body. Okay? So, it is a diffuse emitter. Under these conditions, so we can say that that is a black body, and all real bodies are going to have emissive power lower than that of the black body. Okay. So, now we have Stefan Boltzmann law, wherein which we said that E b equal to sigma t to the power of 4, where sigma is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watts per meter squared Kelvin to the power of 4. And then this was contributed by Stefan and Boltzmann, and Stefan never left university. He was always in his own place. He never left the university. In fact, he never went home also. But Boltzmann was a peripatetic traveler. That is, he used to travel all over the place. And unfortunate, the bad news is that Boltzmann died of suicide. That is, he committed suicide. Perhaps he thought that he did not get the recognition as much he deserved during his lifetime. So, it is a bad news. Maybe Boltzmann would have been alive for few more years, few more laws would have come out. Anyway, so there is, we said that a cavity can be imagined as a perfect black body because it is multiple reflections. Because of multiple reflections, it is going to absorb everything and at the same time it is going to emit everything. Now, the spectral emissive power of a black body is given by Planck's distribution. As you can see that it is a function of lambda and T, and rest are all constants. So, and I know the black body is a diffuse emitter. So, if I calculate emissive power instead of intensity of radiation, pi I lambda comma b lambda comma t is, if I substitute the Planck's distribution, I am going to end up with c 1 upon lambda to the power of 5 exponential of c 2 upon lambda t minus 1. So, c 1 and c 2 are constants. So, now, if I plot this spectral emissive power, I find that this is the spectral emissive power and this is the wavelength plotted for different temperatures. So, what I can see here is that the emissive power increases and decreases, and there is always a maxima at a particular wavelength, and that maxima at any particular temperature can be computed by Wien's displacement law, that is lambda maximum into T equal to 2897.8. So, that is Wien's displacement law, and also it states that any wavelengths below 0.08 micrometer and near about 2000 to 3000 micrometer, there is no contribution of any other waves other than these wavelengths contribution towards thermal energy. That is the important point we need to recognize or realize or emphasize. And one important point Professor Arun emphasized is that area under this curve represents the total emissive power of any body of a black body at that temperature, covering complete thermal radiation wavelengths. Okay. So, he is Professor Wien, and this is the Stefan Boltzmann law. If I integrate this with respect to lambda, so covering all lambdas, I am going to get sigma t to the power of 4, and that is how I end up getting sigma equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 watts per meter squared Kelvin to the power of 4. So, intensity of the black body is equal to E b by pi, that is another way of looking at it. Now the question is, that is where we stopped in the just before signing off for lunch. So, now the question is, now I want to find an emissive power in a particular band of wavelength. It is not from 0 to infinity now. Let us say I want it from lambda 1 to lambda 2, that is 3 micrometer to 5 micrometer or 7 micrometer to 12 micrometer. If I am interested in only band emission, that is what is this band emission. What is the band emission means? I am interested in a particular band. How do I get that band emission? So, that is defined as a fraction. Fraction of the total emission of from a black body, that is in a certain wavelength interval. That is fraction. So, what is that fraction? So, that let us say I define it as 0 to lambda E lambda b d lambda upon 0 to infinity E lambda b d lambda. What is this denominator? What is this denominator? Total emissivity, that is total emissivity, complete spectrum. It is covering the complete spectrum. Whose spectrum it is covering? Black bodies. So, it is black bodies, of course, even in the numerator it is black body only. For a black body, if I cover complete spectrum, what is this E lambda comma b d lambda? Just now we have integrated this and found that that is nothing but sigma t to the power of 4. So, the denominator turns out to be sigma t to the power of 4, but then what is the numerator? That is between, that is the emissive power in a particular wavelength. What is that particular wavelength band? 0 to lambda. So, this fraction between 0 to lambda and 0 to infinity is the fraction. Okay? That fraction is called 0 f 0 to lambda. You see, capital F means fraction. 0 to lambda means I am interested in the emissive power only between 0 to lambda compared to the emissive power of complete spectrum. Which spectrum? Thermal spectrum. That is the spectrum over which the thermal radiation contribution is inherently there. Okay. Now, I will do some algebra. So, what I am doing here is lambda t equal to m, let me call this as lambda t equal to m. So, if I differentiate this, I get d lambda into t. This, remember, all this I am doing at a particular temperature. Temperature is fixed. D lambda into t equal to d m. So, d lambda equal to d m upon t. So, when lambda equal to 0, m is 0. When lambda equal to lambda, m is lambda t. So, if I substitute that, E lambda comma b d lambda t, what will happen? D lambda becomes now d lambda t upon t. So, t is there in the denominator, and you have now the limits have changed from 0 to lambda to 0 to lambda t. So, 0 to lambda t E lambda comma b d lambda of t upon sigma t to the power of 5. What is E lambda comma b lambda comma t? That is pi I lambda comma b lambda comma t. What is pi? What is this I? Intensity of radiation, that is Planck's distribution, that is C 1 upon lambda to the power of 5 exponential of C 2 upon lambda t minus 1. Is that okay? You see 1 by pi is there, that pi has vanished. Okay? So, I get 0 to lambda t C 1 d of lambda t upon sigma Where did this sigma come from? Yes, it is there in, see what am I doing? I am substituting this in the above equation. So, if I substitute this in this equation, what am I getting? See, E lambda comma b is C 1 all this blah blah blah, and in the denominator I have sigma t to the power of 5, but here lambda to the power of 5 is sitting. So, lambda and t I will combine and make it as lambda t to the power of 5. So, what is this whole of this which is there in the integral? It is a function of what? Lambda t. So, fraction of the total emission from a black body, we have shown that it can be represented as a function of lambda t. Why are we doing this? Because every time we do not want to calculate this fraction, once we want to calculate this fraction for different lambda t's and keep it and use the table again and again. That is what we are going to do. So, again the same thing, I have not done, this font is big, that is all. F 0 lambda is 0 lambda t C 1 d lambda t upon sigma lambda t to the power of 4 exponential of C 2 upon lambda t minus 1 f of lambda t. If I have to understand what is this fraction, this is the fraction. This is the fraction of the emissive power compared to the total emissive power I am looking for. Is that okay? And that fraction happens to be a function of lambda t, that is f lambda t. Okay? So, now this has been integrated because I know C 1, C 2. If I choose a lambda t, I should be able to integrate this. I can use either Simpson's one third rule or trapezoidal rule and integrate this. You can also do this integration using Excel sheet, simple Excel sheet. Okay. So, that is for 0 to lambda t. Now, what if I have to find a fraction from lambda 1 to lambda 2? That is, let me show that pictorially. That means, earlier I was trying to find this fraction. What if I want to find the fraction of emission between lambda 1 and lambda 2? That is the area under the curve which has been shown. That is, it is emissive power from 0 to lambda 2 minus of emissive power 0 to lambda 1 upon sigma t to the power of 4. Same thing whatever we did for 0 to lambda, I can do the same thing and show that fraction of lambda, fraction of the total emission between lambda 1 to lambda 2 is equal to fraction between 0 to lambda 2 minus fraction of 0 to lambda 1. Okay? Is that okay? Similarly, if I have to find the intensity of radiation, I lambda b lambda t upon sigma t to the power of 4, this is given by this. So, I can compute this ratio also by computing this. Okay? So, all these are plugged in here. For a given lambda t, I get the fraction f of 0 comma lambda, and this is the ratio, that is this ratio I lambda b lambda comma t sigma t to the power of 5. Otherwise, every time I have to compute this. Instead of computing that, intensity of radiation has been given, and this is given as a ratio. This intensity whatever I get upon I lambda comma b at lambda maximum comma t, that is intensity of the radiation of the black body at a given temperature at maximum, at a wavelength at which the emissive power is maximum. So, that is what is this ratio. Now, let us just quickly solve a problem so that we understand this concept of band emission. Okay. Consider a large isothermal enclosure that is maintained at a uniform temperature of 2000 Kelvin. Calculate the emissive power of the radiation that emerges from a small aperture on the enclosure surface. If you see the figure, this is the enclosure and this is the small object, and the enclosure is sitting at 2000 Kelvin. Now, what is the wave? Calculate the emissive power of the radiation that emerges from the small aperture on the enclosure surface. How will I calculate this? What is the emissive power? There is a small object. There is a small object. Okay. So, it has to undergo through multiple reflections. So, it does not matter what is the emissivity of the small object. If the small object inside a large cavity can be considered as a black body. So, if I do that, so the emissive power is sigma t to the power of 4. No, sorry. What is that question asked? Calculate the emissive power of the radiation that emerges from a small aperture on the enclosure surface. Who is emitting this? The enclosure surface is emitting this. So, enclosure surface is at what temperature? 2000. Whatever is emitting from this surface only has to get out through the aperture. So, the emitting thing what is the emitting thing? That is sigma t to the power of 4. So, that is what has been substituted and we are getting 900 kilowatts per meter square. Okay. So, now what is the next part? This is the easiest part. What is the next part? What is the wavelength lambda 1 below which 10% of the emission is concentrated? That means what? What is the fraction or what is the wavelength lambda 1 below which 10% of the emission is concentrated? What is this 10%? That means F 0 lambda 1 is 0.1. What is the wavelength at which F of 0 lambda 1 is 0.1? That is the question. Is that okay, ma'am? Is that okay? Fine. So, you get F of 0 lambda 1 is 0.1. So, now, how do I get that lambda 1? How do I get lambda 1? F of 0 lambda, I have to just go back and see this table. What is this table showing? What is this table showing? Lambda t and F 0 lambda. For this problem, for now, these two columns are not important for us. What is given? F 0 lambda has been given to be 0.1. At what lambda t it is equal to 0.1? Somewhere between 2000 and 2200, little below 2200. If I am right, it is 2198. If I interpolate that, if I am right, no, 2195. 2198 is that maximum Wien's displacement law. Sorry, this problem I get lambda 1 t equal to 2195 micrometer Kelvin. So, how do I get this lambda 1 now? What is temperature? Temperature is given to be 2000 Kelvin. So, if I substitute lambda 1 t equal in lambda 1 t for t 2000 Kelvin, if I substitute, I am going to get lambda 1 as 1.1 micrometer. What was the question answered now? The wavelength at which 10% of the emission, this figure is wrong, this complete thing is this green colored thing should have displaced a little bit here and this is lambda 1. So, this has got distorted. That is, what I am trying to say is, this fraction is found to be 0.1 and this is lambda 1. Okay. So, that is what is being shown here, that is the figure. So, this is the emissive power. Now, what is the next part? What is the wavelength lambda 2 above which 10% of the emission is concentrated? That means what? That is, what is the wavelength lambda 2 above which only 10% of the energy, that is, this is 10% of the total emissive power is concentrated. That means, what is F 0 lambda 2? F 0 lambda 2 should be 0.9. So, now life is easy again. F 0 lambda 2 equal to 0.9. That is, how did I get this? Area under the curve is 1, fraction area under the curve is 1. So, 1 minus 0.1 gives me 0.9. That is what I have done here in this problem. So, F lambda 2 to infinity, lambda 2 to infinity, what is that infinity? This is infinity. Lambda 2 to infinity is 1 minus F 0 to lambda 2, that is 1 minus 0.1, you get 0.9. So, now lambda 2 I should be looking for in the table, where at which lambda, at what lambda 2 t, this is fraction is 0.9. I know the font is very small, I am sorry about that. That is, it is somewhere between 9000 and 9500. Okay. So, you cannot see it, 9000 and 9500. Okay. So, lambda 2 t, lambda 2 t, I get 9382 micrometer Kelvin if I interpolate. So, I get lambda 2, please add this on to this, lambda 2 equal to 4.69 micrometer, 4.69 micrometer is the wavelength. Now, what is the next question asked? The question is not over, determine the maximum spectral emissive power and the wavelength at which this emission occurs. Is that right? That is, where does the maximum emission, what is the condition for which or what is the wavelength at which the maximum emissive power occurs? Have we studied any law for this? Wien's displacement law. That is lambda maximum. If you see the Wien's displacement law, we see that if you go to Wien's displacement law, what is Wien's displacement law saying? If you see this Planck's distribution, it is saying that these peaks are curve fitted by an equation lambda max into T equal to 2897.8 micrometer. For our problem, I know the T. What is T? 2000 Kelvin. If I substitute T equal to 2000, I will get my lambda max. So, that is this lambda max. That lambda max equal to 1.45 micrometer. At 1.45 micrometer, I can get the, what is that? The emissive power at which it is maximum. See, because we defined this fraction, because the table is there, we are able to solve this problem very easily. Otherwise, you have to sit down and do the integration every time. That is not easy. So, that is the reason this table helps us in easing out our problems very, very fast. Okay. Now, what is the next portion? Determine the maximum spectral emissive power. We found just the wavelength. What is the spectral emissive power? How will you find that? How will you find that spectral emissive power? How will you find that? Again from the table. Now, you will realize. You have I lambda comma b lambda t upon lambda comma b lambda lambda max comma t. Now, let me just see what exactly is going on here. Yeah. So, that is in the third column, I will get that and then I will multiply. Okay, fine. That is, you see the third column. What is the third column? It is, if you are not able to see, let me write that. That is, I have the third column as I, just help me out. I lambda comma b, yes Samir, upon lambda, no, you are not helping me, lambda comma b upon sigma t to the power of, sigma t to the power of 5, I lambda comma b sigma t to the power of 5. Of course, I lambda comma b is function of lambda and t. This ratio is there. So, I know that black body is a diffuse emitter. If I get the intensity of radiation, I can get the emissive power. So, I know the temperature, I know sigma. All that I need to do is at lambda max T equal to whatever I had got, that is the maximum wavelength at which, that is at maximum, when does the maximum spectral emissive power be there? At lambda max T equal to 2198.5. For 2198.5, what is this ratio? I am sure that at least should be there. Okay. I can take 2200 thing. That is, it is 5.89649 into 10 to the power of minus 5. Let me see, is that what I have taken? Yeah. Is that right? No. I have taken something else. Oh no, 2898. I saw wrong. 2898 means I should be seeing 2900. So, that is something around 7.23 into 10 to the power of minus 5. So, if I put that 7.23 into 10 to the power of minus 5, I think above values are something wrong. Please be careful with this table. There is something wrong with this table. In the top, these three values are wrong and I guess these two values are also wrong. 10 to the power of minuses are missing. Okay. We will check that and correct it back. So, if I put that ratio, that is 0.722 into 10 to the power of minus 4 and sigma t to the power of 5, sigma is 5.67 into 10 to the power of minus 8 and t is 2000 to the power of 5, I get 1.31 into 10 to the power of 5. I am not interested in spectral intensity, I am interested in emissive power. So, to get the emissive power, because I know the black, it is black body, all that I need to do is multiply by pi. I will be getting watt per meter squared micrometer. This is the emissive power at the maximum spectral emissive power at the wavelength at which it can be maximum. Fine. So, So, now what is the next part of the question? What is the irradiation incident on the small object placed inside the enclosure? That should also be equal to what? Sigma T to the power of 4. Whatever is being emitted by the enclosure has to be absorbed by my black body because it is very small. Okay. So, irradiation of any small object inside the enclosure may be approximated as being equal to the emission from a black body at the enclosure surface temperature. So, because of which I can compute that. So, this is same as what we had written here. Okay. So, that is how we have solved this problem, that is band emission. So, this concept what we have elaborated in the last 1/2 hour is that we have introduced the concept of band emission, that is what is the fraction of emissive power between two wavelengths. That band emission concept we have elaborated, and for one time these integrations, these integrals are integrated and kept in the form of a table. And now I can, using this table, I can calculate the intensity of radiation and the fractions at any particular wavelength. So, that is the, that is what we have learnt from this, what is this, band emission. So, there is another problem, I am not going to solve this problem, I would request you to solve it yourself because it is not so difficult problem. Now, let me introduce, for next 1/2 hour I am going to spend on some properties which I have been postponing since morning. That is, we are going to introduce 3 properties or 4 properties: emissivity, absorptivity, reflectivity, transmissivity. First is emissivity. Okay. So, if you see here, I am giving definitions. Why I am flashing all these transparencies is because morning Professor Arun said 4 things. One is, things can vary spectrally. I can have things can vary direction on the basis of directionality, and I can have total, and I can also have hemispherical. So, based on these 4 definitions, we will define emissivity also as 4 different definitions. So, if I define emissivity, similarly I would have defined for absorptivity, transmissivity and reflectivity. I am not going to define for absorptivity, transmissivity and reflectivity. Whatever I am defining for emissivity is valid for all others, but everything is there in the notes. I would request you to see the notes, but I am going to define you only the emissivity. Okay. So, what is black body? Black body is an ideal emitter. No surface can emit more than a black body, but all real surfaces are going to emit less than the black body. So, that how much it is less is characterized by emissivity. Emissivity is the radiation emitted by a real surface to the radiation emitted by a black body. Remember, the pointer at the same temperature. Both numerator and denominator has to be written, that is the radiation emitted by the surface at the same temperature. Radiation emitted by a real surface at a given temperature upon radiation emitted by a black body at the same temperature. That is what we mean. Okay. So, that is emissivity. Okay. Now, emissivity is going to vary, as I said, spectrally, and this is spectral distribution. If I have, this is the black body and this is real surface. Okay. The real surface cannot be above this, it can only be below this. That is why the emissive power of a real surface is going to be lower than that of black body. This ratio, if I have to calculate at every wavelength, if I calculate the ratio, that is what is called as spectral emissivity. Now, emissive power can also change with the direction, okay, can also change with the direction. So, if I have to take the directionality into account, black body is has no preference to the direction, but real surface has preference to direction. Okay. So, if I have to take into account, then I have to have directional dependency also in my emissivity definition. So, real surface will have directional distribution, it need not be diffuse, unlike black body, and real surfaces can have spectral distribution also. Of course, black body also had, even black body also is having spectral distribution. So, is the real surface. Okay. There is nothing new there, But directionality wise, real surfaces and black surfaces are different. Okay. Now, what is the definition? What is this telling? Spectral directional emissivity. First is, let me restate, spectral directional emissivity. All these definitions, four definitions I am writing, let me write these headings so that we do not lose track of what we are doing. Spectral directional emissivity. Spectral, I want all of you to write along with me, spectral directional emissivity, that is epsilon lambda theta comma phi. This is what we mean by spectral directional emissivity. And all these definitions, I am going to state that at a particular temperature, at a given temperature. Okay? So, that is comma T. This subscript only says that it is varying with lambda, it is varying with direction theta comma phi at a given temperature T. Now, next definition, what is that? This is spectral directional emissivity. Next is total directional emissivity. Total directional emissivity. Okay. So, what does the total directional emissivity? Total means what? It is spectrally averaged, spectrally averaged. So, that is why I am seeing here only epsilon theta, theta comma phi comma t, epsilon theta comma phi comma t. So, it is usually called, it is a function of that, it is usually written as epsilon theta. That is what you are written here, epsilon theta, it is a function of theta comma phi comma t. Now, next one is spectral hemispherical emissivity. Spectral, it is all English, there is nothing very different or difficult. Spectral hemispherical emissivity, that is epsilon lambda, lambda comma t. Note here, epsilon is not a function of theta and phi because it is averaged over complete hemisphere. So, epsilon lambda, lambda comma t, here it is only a function of lambda and t. And the last definition is total hemispherical emissivity. Total hemispherical emissivity. It should be a function of what? This epsilon should be a function of what? It is spectrally averaged, that is why it is called total, and it is in all directions it is averaged, that is for complete hemisphere it is averaged, that is why it is hemispherical. So, it is neither dependent on lambda nor dependent on theta comma phi, then it should be dependent on what? Only temperature. So, epsilon T. Okay? So, spectral directional, total directional, spectral hemispherical, total hemispherical, that is all. You see, directional is common, hemispherical is common, otherwise you have spectral, total, spectral, total. Is that okay? So, now having understood this, let us define each one on a fast note. Epsilon lambda comma theta, lambda comma theta phi comma t equal to I lambda comma e lambda comma theta comma theta comma phi comma t upon I lambda comma b lambda comma t. What does this mean? What does the numerator mean? It means that this is the radiation intensity at a particular wavelength in the direction theta comma phi at a given temperature upon black body. Will black body have theta comma phi? No, because it is diffuse. But black body intensity, is it dependent on wavelength? Yes, it is dependent on wavelength and it is dependent on temperature. Temperature we will not keep stating every time, because both in the numerator and the denominator in all the definitions temperature is going to be same. So, temperature is not a variable at all for now. So, this is the intensity of radiation emitted at a particular wavelength in a particular direction at a given temperature upon intensity of radiation emitted by a black body at the same wavelength and temperature. Is that okay? I am not writing this again. I hope you all have notes and you are seeing this. Now, total directional emissivity. So, epsilon theta, theta comma phi comma t equal to I e intensity of radiation emitted in the direction theta comma phi t upon I b t. Why here lambda is missing? Because I have averaged for all wavelengths. Okay? But this averaging I have done in only one direction, that is theta comma phi direction. In only one direction I have done in the numerator. In the denominator there is nothing like direction, because in all directions it is same, it is uniform. So, total directional emissivity is given by I e theta comma phi comma t. Now, what is spectral hemispherical emissivity? Now, I am going to ask you a question. Spectral hemispherical emissivity, I am not writing intensity, I am writing emissive power. Why? You notice, please notice this. Spectral hemispherical emissivity, I am not writing intensity, I am writing emissive power. Why? Intensity is the only one which is having directionality, but the emissive power, it is integrated over all directions theta comma phi. That is what we realized when we defined intensity and emissive power. So, that is the reason why we have defined spectral hemispherical emissivity as E lambda lambda comma t upon E lambda comma b lambda t. Please note this, please note this, it does not occur to us that easily. If you are not understood, also go back and think, you will understand. Go back to the definition of spectral intensity and spectral emissive power, you will understand this. This is a subtle thing, because student is going to ask you, how did I write this? Okay, you need to know that. Now, what is that I am going to do? Relation between spectral hemispherical emissivity and directional emissivity. How do I do this? Let me start off with spectral hemispherical emissivity. That is, spectral hemispherical emissivity is epsilon lambda lambda t is given by E lambda lambda t. What is E lambda lambda t given by? Is I lambda E lambda comma theta comma phi comma t. Note this. Why am I writing always subscript E? Emitted. If you are doing absorptivity, you will have to take irradiation. Okay? So lambda comma E is lambda comma theta comma phi comma t, and then for directionality you have to take sin theta cos theta d phi. This is the, where did I get this from? This is the definition of emissive power. Okay. So, if I take that and integrate that, and on the denominator, in the denominator I have I lambda comma b lambda comma t sin theta cos theta d phi. But I lambda comma b is independent of direction. I can pull this fellow out of the integration and integrate only sin theta cos theta d phi. That is what I am doing here. So, I am pulling this out, I am pulling this I lambda comma b and pulling this out and getting this into the below the denominator. I can take this I lambda comma b lambda comma t anywhere. Why? Because if I pull it in, it only means that it is a constant, and the integration I am doing with respect to direction. When I say constant, not with respect to wavelength or with respect to temperature, but in terms of it is uniform in all directions. This integration is with respect to direction, so I can push it in that integral. So, I lambda E lambda comma theta comma phi comma t upon lambda comma B lambda comma t. What is this ratio? What is this ratio? We had just defined that ratio is this. So, it is spectral directional emissivity. So, if I substitute that as spectral directional emissivity, I have sin theta cos theta d phi. And if I do this integration, which I am not going to do, if I do that integration, you are going to get epsilon lambda lambda comma t equal to 2 into 0 to pi by 2 epsilon lambda theta sin theta cos theta d theta. Here, in this, I have taken epsilon lambda comma theta as independent of phi. Azimuthal angle, I have taken it as independent of phi. So, that is why I am able to pull out that phi and say that as 2 phi. If I integrate d phi, I get 2 pi. So, that is what I have done. You can ask me and say, how did you do that? You cannot do that. Yes, I cannot do that. That is an assumption I have made. Okay? So, I have no justification in making that assumption. There is no justification in making that assumption. I have just, to make it look little better, I have made that assumption. If you are a purist, your definition of connection between spectral hemispherical emissivity and spectral directional emissivity ends here. Okay? So, now what is the last definition left out? Total hemispherical emissivity. Here also I am not using intensity, I am using emissive power, because it is hemispherical. The moment you see hemispherical, you are going to get into emissive power. Why? You please sit down and think. Okay? So, epsilon equal to emissive power at a given temperature upon total hemispherical emissivity equal to emissive power at temperature T upon emissive power of the black body at temperature T, at the same temperature. So, what is this E of T? Just now we have derived this. What is this? This is nothing but, what is this? How did I write this? This is this. E lambda T, I can write that as epsilon lambda T into E lambda comma B lambda T. That is what I have done here. Now, that is it. So, these are the four definitions which we have defined. That is spectral directional emissivity, total directional emissivity, spectral hemispherical emissivity and total hemispherical emissivity. These are the four definitions we have introduced. So, now, having introduced them, before I go to various band emissions and things like that, similarly one can define what is called as, okay, I have not, let me formally define before I go to the band emissivities, I will define what is called as absorptivity, reflectivity and transmissivity. It is quite straightforward. I think every one of us are very comfortable with this. If there is an irradiation G, all of that cannot pass through, that is some amount of it is transmitted, that is tau g is transmitted, rho g is reflected and alpha g is absorbed. If I combine these three, I should be getting g. So, g equal to g absorbed plus g reflected plus g transmitted, which is in which g absorbed is equal to alpha g, rho here g reflected equal to rho g, g transmitted equal to tau g. g gets cancelled out everywhere. I get alpha plus rho plus tau equal to 1. So, what is alpha? Alpha is absorptivity. What is rho? Rho is reflectivity. What is tau? Tau is transmissivity. Compared to incident radiation, how much is absorbed is absorptivity. Compared to incident radiation, how much is reflected is reflectivity. Compared to incident radiation, how much is transmitted through that body is transmissivity. So, for opaque surfaces, generally for opaque surfaces, transmissivity is 0. Opaque means solid. You take any solid plate, transmissivity is 0. Okay? So, I will have absorptivity plus reflectivity. Later on, we will show that absorptivity is equal to reflectivity under restricted conditions, but that we will do little later on. But that is why we first teach emissivity and then come to absorptivity, transmissivity and reflectivity. So, I have absorptivity plus reflectivity equal to 1. For opaque surfaces. Now, similar definitions, the way we define spectral directional emissivity, we can define spectral directional absorptivity, spectral directional reflectivity, spectral hemispherical absorptivity and reflectivity. All definitions roll in the same manner. So, I do not have to go through all that. I need to make differentiation is that for absorptivity, I have to consider intensity that is absorbed. For reflectivity, I have to consider intensity that is reflected. That is all the definition. Or instead of emissive power, I need to take for absorption irradiation. Similarly, for reflection also. That is all the differences. Otherwise, all definitions roll to the, come to the same way or turn out to be looking similar. Complete derivations. I would request you to look into this in the, sit down and rederive or rework what all the definitions in the same way I did for emissivities, four definitions. Okay. I think if we do that, now we can come to what is called as emissivity function, like band emission. Emissivity is also not going to be spectrally same everywhere. We said that there is going to be spectral emissivity. If you take emissivity, usually this emissivity is measured by what is called as FTIR spectrometer, Fourier transform infrared spectrometer. So, if you put this, if you put your surface under FTIR spectrometer, let us not get into how it works and things like that, we will be digressing. So, if we get into FTIR spectrometer, if you put my surface under FTIR spectrometer, I typically get an emissivity at a given temperature, typically FTIR does at room temperature. So, if you do that, you are going to get the emissivity something like this. Okay. So, that means what? Emissivity is a continuous function of lambda. Now, I need to break this. So, this is the function. What am I assuming now? Between 0 to lambda 1, I will make a reasonable assumption and say that that is constant, and that constant is epsilon 1. Now, between lambda 1 to lambda 2, instead of this sinusoidal wave looking thing, I will convert and imagine that it is a square wave. It is looking something like a square. Okay? It is looking like a square, and here the peak emissivity is epsilon 2, and then it is dropping to epsilon 3 at lambda equal to lambda 2, and subsequently it is constant whose emissivity is epsilon 3. Now, the question is, what is the average emissivity? If this is the question, if this is the total thing, this is the emissivity function as lambda with spectrally, that is how it is, if it is varying, what is the average emissivity? How do I compute this average emissivity? So, that is what is given here. How do I do this? I will be taking the recourse of band emission. How did I write this equation? What is this equation? What is this equation? Emissivity by definition is what? Let me just take the range 0 to lambda 1. Emissivity is what? Emissive power of a real surface upon emissive power of a black body. Emissive power of a black body is Eb. But what is emissive power of a real surface? Emissivity into emissive power of the black body. But emissivity epsilon 1, I can take out from this integral only within the range of 0 to lambda 1. So, epsilon 1 into E b lambda d lambda within the limits 0 to lambda 1. Similarly, epsilon 2 is epsilon 2 into E b lambda d lambda between the limits lambda 1 to lambda t upon E b plus epsilon 2 into E b lambda d lambda lambda 2 to infinity upon E b. So, epsilon 1, what is this? What is this, by the way, this fraction? We have just defined that is the band emission fraction f of 0 to lambda 1. What is this fraction? F of lambda 1 to lambda 2. What is this fraction? Lambda 2 to infinity. What is this fraction? F of lambda 2 to infinity. So, that fraction band emission idea is helping us even here to get the average emissivity. Let us quickly solve a problem. What is the problem given is, emissivity is given to be epsilon 1 equal to 0.3 from for lambda 0 to 3 micrometer. Let me see if there is any figure. No. Epsilon 1 equal to 0.3 for lambda 0 to 3 micrometer, and between 3 micrometer to 7 micrometer epsilon 2 is 0.8, and between 7 micrometer to infinity it is 0.1. Why am I looking for the figure? This is the figure. Epsilon 1 is 0.3, lambda 1 is 3 micrometer, and epsilon 2 is 0.8, lambda 2 is 7 micrometer, and epsilon 3 is 0.1. So, that is what is this. So, all that I need to do is apply this. Okay. If I do the application and I need to get the band emission, what is that I need? I need to know the temperature. That is, the temperature of my surface is 800 Kelvin. So, if I have to find that lambda t, so there are only two wavelengths, that is 3 into 800 is 2500 micrometer. If you see the table, I am not going to go to the table. If you see the table, you get F03 as 0.140256 and lambda 2T is 5600 micrometer Kelvin. And if you see that fraction, let us go and see, because my students here are seeing. So, that means everyone is tempted to see. 5600 is 0.701046. So, if I that fraction, if I substitute that here, that is 0.701046. So, what is my relation? Epsilon 1 F 0 lambda 1, epsilon 1 is 0.3, F 0 lambda 1 is 0.14 plus epsilon 2 is 0.8. What is F lambda 1 to lambda 2? What is this? Yes, F lambda 0 to lambda 2 minus of F 0 to lambda 1, that is what we did. So, 0.701046 minus 0.140256 plus 0.1 into this is what? This is 1 minus, that is whole area under the curve minus that fraction. So, 1 minus of 0.701046, you get a net emissivity of 0.521. Now, if I have to find out what is the emissive power, net emissive power from my body, epsilon sigma t to the power of 4. What is my net epsilon? Epsilon is 0.521. If I put that, this is the surface, my surface is going to emit 12.1 kilowatts per meter square of radiation energy. That is what we understand from emissivities. I think there is another problem. I am not going to solve this problem. You please go through this problem yourself. Okay. So, because essentially it is dealing with directional distribution and spectral normal distribution and spectral emissivity. So, please go through this problem. Every step is there here. Please go through this problem. You will be able to understand it yourself. I think I have loaded too much in 45 minutes. So, I will not take up this emissivity variation with theta and things like that. Tomorrow morning, we will start off the day with how do we get the emissivity, how do we measure emissivity, for example, and how do we get the absorptivity and how does it vary, why is emissivity dependent on surface temperature and absorptivity dependent only on the source temperature. We will try to understand all of this tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock.